Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. How are you, my dear student? How are your different homes? May Allah continue to protect us all. Amen. Today, we want to continue from where we stopped during our last contact. During our last contact, we are discussing method of improving our farm animals. And we have discussed number one, which is introduction. Today, we want to move further into number two, which is selection. What is selection? Selection refers to the process of choosing animals of proven qualities as parents, so that such qualities are passed on to the offspring. Or selection is the situation whereby an individual that is preferred to another for the production of the next generation is picked. Or selection is the system of picking an animal from a group based on those phenotypic features exhibited by the animal. That's selection. Selection is the word. Is the process of choosing animals of proven qualities as parents, so that such qualities are passed on to the world, to the offspring. Do you get it now? That's method of what? Choosing an animal of proven qualities. Do you get it now? That's what selection is all about. Now, what are those things that you want? What are the features that, when they say, on those what? Phenotypic features. What are those phenotypic features? Number one, we have fertility rate. Look at it now. Number two, infantile mortality. That is, number of young ones that used to die from that particular animal. Look at it now. Three, we have growth rate. How is he growing? This growth rate. Look at it now. Number four. Size of the animal. Number five, milk quality and quantity. Look at it now. The quality and quantity of milk produced by the animal. Another one is a rate of egg laying. You get it now. Rate of egg laying. Another one. Color of egg shell. Another one. Fat and meat quality. Next one, resistance to what? To diseases. Now, let's say generally, all animals used for breeding must be what? Must be fit and healthy. That's generally. Well, you can use a particular animal for what? For breeding, the animal was what? Must be fit and must be healthy. Do you get it now? Now, what are the types of selection that we have? We say broadly, there are two types of what? There are two types of selection. Number one, that's a natural selection. This can be termed survivor of the fittest. What? Survivor of the fittest. That is the ability of an animal, individually or in group, to wade through unfavorable conditions and survive to reproduce, and then discarding or rejecting those that are what? Unable to survive. That means what? That's what is telling that survival was of the one that what? The one that what? That can pass through the rigors. Look at it now. And able to what? To survive it, and still growing. To what? To the rate of what? Of reproducing another young ones. Do you get it now? You know those ones that are what? They cannot survive. I mean those ones would have been what? I mean died, have you? Those ones that are what? That survive. They can survive. In the world, in the face of the all those harsh conditions, these are the what? The ones that survive, the ones that what? That have been selected. Do you get it now? That's naturally. Number two, we have artificial selection. We have what? We have artificial selection. This is based on what? Man's intelligence and experience. On what he wants on his animal. You get it now? When you say artificial selection, those ones, you use your intelligence, you use your brain. But this is the quality I want. I want these particular qualities in my animals. Do you get it now? See? Artificial selection include the following. Number one, we have individual or mass selection. See, this is when an animal or group of animals are selected based on their what? Based on their own performance or merit, such as birth weight, winning weight, feed conversion factor, etc. We say individual or mass selection. That means these particular animals are selected based on what? Based on their own performance. Based on the what? On their product. What they are able to what? To produce. That's what you use. That's just used in what? In selecting them. Do you get it now? Then you use that maybe the feed conversion. When you give them little feed, they grow very well. Do you get it now? Do you get it? Or their birth when they give birth, the weight of their what? Of their young ones, the size of their young ones. Do you get it now? Those are the things what you use in picking them. The what? The merit of the animal. The merit of the selected animal. Right? The quality it possesses. That's what you use in what in selecting it. Number two, we have progeny selection. We have what? Progeny selection. Animals are selected based on the what? Performance of their offspring or young ones. When they say progeny, progeny is what? It's young ones. While the mothers of such other animals which cannot meet the set standard are called or discarded. Do you get it now? The animal you select, you base it on the performance of the young ones, of the offspring of that animal. That's what you use in what? In selecting it. Do you get it now? The progeny, the young one it gives. It produces what you use in what? In selecting it. The next one is called pedigree selection. What is a pedigree? Pedigree has to do with family or your ancestors. I mean, the ancestors, huh? Do you get it now? See, animals are selected based on the what? Based on the performance of their ancestors. As characters or traits are inherited by what? By offspring. Yes. You see, pedigree selection. Animal is the animal is selected based on the what? Performance of the what? Of the ancestors. Just like when they say your grandfather. Do you get it now? Look at their lineage. This is how they are. Do you get it now? Look at the sense of the animal. When you look at the mother that give her to eat, this is how they do. Do you get it now? When you base your selection on that, on the what? On the lineage of the animal, on the family of the animal. Do you get it now? How they are coming, where they are coming from. Do you get it? That's what they use in what? In selecting the animal. Do you get it? How they are what? What they use? You see, this system can be possible when there is adequate record keeping. Yes. When there is what? When there is adequate what? Record keeping. That is what? When there is adequate record keeping. When there is adequate what? Record keeping. Do you get it? When there is adequate record keeping. The next one is what? The next one is family selection. That means what? Family selection. This is usually done in a large family. This is usually done what? In a large family. The major consideration here is what? Performance of the what? Of the relatives of the what? Of the relatives in a family. Animals whose families have good characteristics are what? Are selected. You got it now? Just like, the one that has a good family background for human being. You get it now? That you know what you are going for. Now, what are the advantages of selection? What are the advantages of selection? Number one, animal judged to possess desired characteristics are what? Are chosen, yes. The animal you are going to select are the one that what? You have carried a lot of research on the animal. You have studied the animal. When you are sure that this one, is the best. You are going to select. Now you don't just select the animal. You are what? You want that what? That possess or that have those qualities that you want. Those are the ones that you go for. Number two, selection might reduce cost of maintenance of animals of what? Undesirable characters which are rejected outrightly. Yes. That means you don't have any time. Don't have a couple of time to say let me have all of them so that I will study them. And no, you don't have time for that. You go for the what? For the best among them. So that the money you're supposed to use in feeding both productive and unproductive form is no longer there. You only select the one that is good. Those are the ones that what you go for. Do you get it now? Those ones that lack the quality, you reject them outrightly. You don't waste time on them. You discard them right away. Okay? Number three, it can check spread of disease. Yes. But those ones that you judge as the best, those are the ones you go for. There's no time for let me pick them. I'll be managing them. I'm gonna treat them. No, you don't have time for that. You go for the what? You go for the best. And select the best and what? Right, this will prevent what? Spreading of disease among the what? Among the animals. Do you get it now? Don't have time for that. Number four, best animals available are selected. And there is what? There is likelihood of what? Good performance. What? The one you go for, the one you selected are the best. Do you get it now? Go for the best. And all things being equal. All things being equal, with God on one side, you are going to have good result once you go for the best. Do you get it now? Let's now go disadvantages of selection. Let's now go to what? Disadvantages of what? Selection. Number one, selection requires experience and expertise, which may be unavailable to the what? To the handler. Yes. That means the person that wants to do selection, if it's not experienced, if it's not professional, he may not be able to what? To select the best. Do you get it now? Because he doesn't have the experience, doesn't have the what? The expertise. Do you get it now? Number two, it is very expensive in terms of money and time to carry. Do you get it now? It's going to cost you a lot of money. And to cost you a lot of, require a lot of what? Time for you to what? For you to carry it out. For you to be able to do proper selection, you have to spend a lot of money. Well, you have to pick among the best. Well, you have to what? It will take time. Well, you can do that. You get it now. Of course, a lot of what? A lot of money. You have to feed all of them. But you now select the what? So that you now pick the what? The best among them. Now, number three. Selection exercise might be tedious. Yeah, it's a tedious exercise. You say what? It's a tedious exercise. You say what? It's a tedious exercise. I mean, it requires time, it requires a lot of things from you. You have to do what? You have to do a lot of work before you what? Before you can do it successfully. Do you get it now? It's tedious. You say what? It's a tedious exercise. Number four, no new desirable traits are introduced. But once you do your selection all at once, you have them. There's no what, no magic can be what can be produced, because it can be generated, can be gotten. You get it now? Because it's what you have. It's what you have that what you get result for. Not that you are going to have any new desirable one. Do you get it now? Now let's now go to what to consider in animal selection. What are those things you have? You need to consider before you do your selection. One is a body what? Body shape. Body what? Body shape. You have to consider what? Body shape. You have to know the body what? Body composition of the animal. The one you are going to select must be what? Must be the one that is big enough, is robust, is fine. The one that is attractive to anybody that can see it. You get it now? That's what you must go for. That you have to consider what? The body shape. Number two, we have legs. Anyone you're going to pick must what? Must have a strong and hardy legs. You get it now? You need that. Because the animal we need to what? We need to carry pregnancy. The animal we need to what? To mount other, if it's male. If it's a bull, you must what? Maybe what? You need to mount other animals. That means you must not go for lame animals. But lame animal cannot do the what? The exercise you want to give to the animal. Do you get it now? You have to have strong and hardy legs. Do you get it now? Number three, coat or plumage color. Yes. Coat or plumage color. You have to consider what the one that have attractive color. That's what you must go for. Do you get it now? The color can attract anybody. Number four, male or female reproductive organs. The one that what? They have good or functional male or female reproductive organs. That's what you go for, because for you to make gain, it's when the animal is what is producing, reproducing. You get it now? That means if the animal cannot produce very well, cannot mate very well, that means what? It will not pay the what? Pay the farm owner. You get it now? Number four, purpose of the animals. Yes, we have to consider, why am I going for this? You get it now? That's what you determine what I go to select. You get it now? That's it. That's it. You get it now? Please read very well. Read over them again. You get it now? And play safe. And what? Play safe. As I do tell you, read very well. Prepare for the exam. And I will protect all of us. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.